on the new Mercedes S-Class. It's more than just a car, this. It's a glimpse into the future. It's a showcase of everything that can be done and everything that everyone else will be doing very soon. You can't get too excited by the basics. It has doors, four of them. Under the bonnet there's an engine, and under the car there are four wheels, which are circular. But you can certainly get excited by some of the garnish. You don't have to do anything as old-fashioned as push buttons in this car. You just tell it what you want it to do. For example, station, radio 2. And it goes to radio 2. Or, station, absolute rubbish. Look, radio 1, it knows! How brilliant's that? This also works for the telephone. You just tell it who you want to call. It even works for the satellite navigation, so you just go, enter destination.
Would you like to spell the name of the town?
W-A-R-S-A-W.
Starting route guidance.
And there you are. Poland! All this means you never have to take your hands off the wheel. But weirdly, you can take your feet off the pedals. You see, it has something called radar-guided cruise control. So I just set it at a speed and it follows the car in front. If it slows down, we slow down. If it speeds up, we speed up. My feet are not on the pedals. Question is, will it actually bring us to a halt when we get to the roundabout up here? Are you going to stop, car? Are you going to be able to do this? Right, the car in front is braking for the roundabout. I'm just going to cover the brake pedal. Just in case. No, we're slowing. How is it doing this? I'm not touching anything. I'm not... The car just stopped itself! I'm going to get out. There's no need to have me in here. You don't need me. The big one on the safety front is a whole new way of stopping. You just touch the brake pedal and then it works out how much braking force is actually needed. Not so little that you run into the car in front, but not so much that you get rear-ended by the car behind. This is where the S-Class really gets into its stride.